In this tutorial video, we're going to cover the basics of working with the text tool in Adobe Flash. The text tool can be found on the toolbar and it's in the form of a T. So I'll click on that tool and it's going to keep the settings that I last had when I used this tool. And I have a changing font, or the font family is called changing, and the font color is white and it's 96 points. And I like that, so I'll go ahead and just click, and it's going to add a text box that's waiting for my first letter. So I'll type animation, and then in order to move this around, I can't necessarily come in here and try to drag it because I'm still in the text tool and it thinks I want to edit the text. So I'll go back to my move tool, move that around, adjust it to where I want it to be, and if I needed to edit that text, I can grab the text tool and click inside or just double click, and you can see it automatically changes back to the text tool. So now I'd like to add a quote about animation from Steven Malhauser. And this is going to be more of a paragraph. I don't want it necessarily to look like a heading that has maybe one or two words and it's big font. I want it to be in an easy to read font. So let's go ahead and try this. I'm going to grab my text tool and go ahead and drag out an area where I want my quote to be. And again, it's 96 and it's changing. So I'll go ahead and make it a little bit smaller and paste the text, and then I can switch to the move tool and adjust it from there, and then I can make my square a little bit less wide. And even though I really like changing for the heading, it is definitely a specialty font, so it should only be for those really large, sparingly used words. If you're going to have something like a paragraph where you want people to easily read it, then you need to really choose easy to read font. You don't have to always pick Arial and Times New Roman. There are a lot of fonts out there that are easy to read, but they give us a little bit more variety than what we're used to in Microsoft Word. Now, I've already made an error. Before I change this to a different font, I've put both my heading and my paragraph text on the same layer. If I don't intend to do anything with this in terms of animation, then that's okay. But if I want to animate my heading in and then animate my quote in, or maybe I just want to animate my heading and not the quote, either way, if I want to animate any of this, they need to be on separate layers. So I'll go ahead and call this one heading and create a new layer and call this quote. And from here, I'll grab the quote and cut it. Go to my quote layer and do edit, paste in place. This is going to put it exactly in the same spot. If I just did a regular paste, it would put it in the exact center of my movie. So now that that's okay, I'm going to choose a different font, and I like Franklin Gothic Medium, and I'm probably going to do, actually I want Franklin Gothic Book. And I'll probably make this about 12 point font. And right now, it's doing justified text, so you see a lot of gaps, and that gets hard for people to read, so I'll just go left alignment. If I had my paragraph on this side of the page, I would do right alignment so that it aligned with the edge of the page. So that's a lot easier for people to read than having that changing font and justified text. Now, if you're not sure of what font you want to use, you could always click in here and then just hit your down arrow on your keyboard and start scrolling through all the fonts until you find something that you like. Now, this is not all that you can do with font. You can do some formatting. Now, this is a classic text and it's static text, meaning it isn't supposed to be interactive. People aren't going to type inside of it. It's not going to return something back to them. This is just text they're supposed to read. Now, this heading is fine the way it is, but let's say I want to make this selectable so somebody can highlight it and copy it and paste it. I can do that. I can click on this text box and I can choose the selectable text. And now when I view this video, I can highlight and now I can copy and paste that text. And you can see as I move over the heading, it doesn't turn to a cursor, so I can't copy and paste it. You have to be really careful though, because next time you do text, let's say you're trying to build a button and you do text. So let's say I want to do start. Even though it looks good, it's still selectable, and that's going to really prevent it from working as a button. So make sure to uncheck the selectable to stop it from doing that. Okay, so from here, we can do a couple of formatting things. We can do center, right, and justify alignment. I can do spacing, and that's just the indent of the start of the paragraph, which would be here. And it's not working, so let's see why it's not doing that. There we go. It just needs to be a lot more. I wasn't being very patient with it. And I can change the line height if I need to. And I can change the margin on the left. And I can change the margin on the right. And again, it's a lot of pixels, or you have to do a kind of extreme number. But that allows you to do somewhat of a typesetting format if you need to. Now, these controls are not as sophisticated as you would find in, let's say, Photoshop or Illustrator or InDesign. But when you switch to ActionScript 3.0, you get something called Tlf Text. And Tlf Text is a type of text that, again, you can do the same thing here, but it's going to have a lot of different options for you, such as tracking, or you can change the kerning, or you can do superscript and subscript, etc. The other types of text that are listed here, static text again is just for reading. Dynamic text is when we want to return something back to a user, and that usually goes in hand with dynamic text and input text. So input text is where they type something in there. So I might ask the user their name, and they type their name in, and on the next screen, I say, welcome, Jessica, welcome, John. And that's the dynamic text, where it takes something from an input area and it gives it, feeds it back to the user. For the most part, you're going to be working with static text. And I have another tutorial video that goes over dynamic and input text, so make sure to check that out if you need to.